babies, feed your baby. You are required to stop any form of movement while the ceremony is ongoing. Please do not wear shades in the hall. Ensure you dust your feet properly before you come into the hall. Finally, in line with the approved guidelines of NCDC, please ensure to maintain social distancing and don't forget to sanitize your hands regularly. Keep your face mask on at all times. May the Lord bless and keep you. Thank you for your cooperation.
Hallelujah. Praise God. It's time to pray for the nation. Hallelujah. Can we just have Leviticus chapter 26, verse 6? Leviticus 26, verse 6. It says, I will give peace in the land, and you shall lie down, and none will make you afraid. I will rid the land of evil beasts, and the sword will not go through your land. Hallelujah. We are praying for Nigeria. We are praying for peace in the nation. Praise God. Can we just be on our feet? Let me be upstanding. We pray for peace. It says, I will rid the land of evil beasts, all those who don't want Nigeria to prosper. The Bible says, I will rid the land of evil beasts. Can we just lift up our voice as we declare in the name of Jesus, peace in the nation of Nigeria, in the name of Jesus, from the north to the south, to the west, to the east of this country, we declare peace in the name of Jesus. We declare peace on our roads. We declare peace in every part of this country in the name of Jesus. Just lift up your voice as we declare in the name of Jesus. We declare this morning peace in the name of Jesus. He said, I will give peace. And the Bible talking, it says, I will give peace, not as the world gives. We declare the peace that comes from God in this nation in the name of Jesus. This is the promise of God concerning us in Christ Jesus, that he would give peace in the land. Therefore, we declare in the name of Jesus, let there be peace in every part of this country. We ask for the divine intervention of God in the name of Jesus. We declare peace in the name of Jesus. We declare safety on our roads in the name of Jesus. We declare peace from the north. We declare peace in the west. We declare peace in the south in the name of the Lord Jesus. Lekotonza branda likatoja barahanda regedebo sopregedida bando sopregediha. That as we go out and as we come in, we declare there is safety. We declare peace in the name of Jesus. And is within the land of every evil beast in the name of Jesus. Sato pakanda brado sobeli madanta ragadilebo janta kateida bado sopranande ligedebo zonde breketila bahateja barakataha regedebo supradabadila brakataha. We declare over Nigeria that it belongs to God. Rado sobregedira mando sobregedila brahateja katapateha lado sobregedia lamanta kabai regedebo sobregedila bado shabrakataha leko bondo zubradiha. It says, thou shalt decree a thing and it shall be established. We speak peace over Nigeria. We speak peace over Nigeria. We speak peace in every path of Nigeria. We speak peace on our roads. We speak peace in every sector of the economy in the name of Jesus. Rado sepregatila mando japrahatala bandele grido sepregadiha. Rado shapatakating the brado sobregadila bahai. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you for peace. 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 And by reason of the peace, there is progress. And by reason of the peace, there is prosperity here. In the name of Jesus. Sakatanda brado sopregatea. Rado shanda baligadonda brenda kato shapandali. Lado sopregedegedebo shanta kalira rosso predina manda brahateya. Lord, we give you praise. Just go ahead and thank him for peace. Thank him for peace, because we serve a prayer answering God in the name of Jesus. We give you praise and glory in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you for Nigeria. We speak peace over Nigeria. We declare in the name of Jesus in the north, in the south, in the west, and in the east of this country, we declare the peace of God. In the name of Jesus, we declare that our roads are safe. In the name of Jesus, we give you praise and we thank you for the peace that comes from you. And because of the peace, we declare progress in Nigeria. In the name of Jesus, we give you praise, oh God. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Can I hear a better believing amen?
Come on, celebrate God this morning. Celebrate our King. Praise God. Welcome your neighbor to the left, to the right. Tell them I'm happy to see you and welcome to church. Amen. Welcome to Grace View Christian Center. This is where favor overcomes labor, grace supersedes sweat, and mercy triumphs over judgment. The year 2021 has been declared as our year of divine deeds. That it will be our experience constantly in the mighty name of Jesus. To the glory of God in Jesus' name. Good news. This is our evangelism month. Are you excited about that? On behalf of Pastor T, I want to thank everyone who came out yesterday. We had a great time yesterday. God bless you immensely in the name of Jesus. For those, shall I say, who did not come, and those who couldn't make it, there are two different things. Hallelujah. I want to implore you next Saturday. Praise God. Pastor, hallelujah. This Saturday is another opportunity for us to go out and expand the kingdom of God. The time is 8 a.m. We'll be meeting here, pray, make some calls, and we go out to invite people to church. Praise God. So please, I want to encourage you, all members, all leaders, please let's come forth on Saturday. All baby dedication and thanksgiving for the month of November. We come up on the 28th of November, 2021. So if you have any form of dedication, thanksgiving, please get to church office and register your name early. Ongoing. Who just gave their life to Christ, who rededicated their life to Jesus Christ, who want to get deeper in their relationship with God. So please come every Tuesday. The time is 6 p.m. Don't just grow. We want to encourage you on Tuesday, 6 p.m. We meet for in-depth teaching in God's Word. Good news. Our midweek service is still bubbling hot and hot every Wednesday. Hallelujah. So I want to encourage you, wherever you are in town, please show up on Wednesday by 6 p.m. The meeting place is still Alpha Hall. Praise God. To all the ladies in the house, we have bride on the 18th. Hallelujah. Praise God. So you all are invited on the 18th. That's a Thursday here in Graceland for our dear sister Linda Oyinyechi. That's in care team. Shion Ara in ROG, and also for Grace Lamai in also ROG. The time is 5:30 p.m. So all ladies, you are all. The following persons, please listen attentively. We'll be having a special meeting with Pastor T after the service at Pastor T's lounge. The following persons, Dr. Iseko Iseko, Dr. Shade Ogiata, Dr. Cynthia, Dr. Chinwe Jill, Dr. Ibrahim Jill, Dr. Omolara Olagunju, and Dr. Uche. Hallelujah. I take the names again. Dr. Iseko Iseko, Dr. Shade Ogiata, Dr. Cynthia, Dr. Chinwe Jill, Dr. Ibrahim Jill, and Dr. Omolara Olagunju with also Dr. Uche. So please. Follow Pastor T online on Instagram. We have Pastor Tunde Ayeni official all together, and also on Facebook. Also follow the church on social media. So please, I want to encourage you, when you see posts from church, let's like, let's share, and let's propagate the kingdom of God. If you have testimony, which you are going to have in Jesus' name, don't keep it to yourself. If you have any form of testimony, meet Pastor Daniel Jiga or myself to share your testimony. We want to be taking testimony like we've been doing before during church services, so that people also can be encouraged by your testimony. This morning, we have our dearly beloved sister who will be sharing her testimony with us in 3 minutes. Hallelujah. 3 minutes. Amen. Let's welcome Sister Uzi as she share testimony with us. Let's jam hands together. Sister Uzi, where are you? Please come forward.
Good morning, church. I'm not used to standing in front of a crowd, so I'll lean on this and give my testimony. It's 3 minutes, so I just want to shorten the testimony. I'm a breakcaster survivor by God's grace. Thank you. I had three brain surgeries, and God saved me, and I was declared cancer-free last year, September. I came back to Nigeria October 5th. I was in the village. So I spoke to my friend, Oyin. She's actually a friend's friend. It's her friend that is actually my friend, to come and stay at her place. I was staying in her place then. It's been miracles from miracles. So when I got to her place, she put Pastor T's preaching on her TV, because each section of... So I watched it, I was thrilled. I said, God, because it made me laugh a lot, and I learned a lot. It encouraged me. Because I actually lost my marriage when I was going through cancer, as my ex left. So I told her, I'll be coming to this church. I love this pastor. And I came to church. Pastor came exactly. He didn't know me that much. He didn't know me then. He just came to my front. He now said, Uzi. He didn't call my name. He just said, God has forgiven you for your past, He has given you a new beginning, something like that. Just that was what he said meant. And I was like shocked. I didn't even know. It was my friend that tapped me and said, Uzi, it's you he's talking about. I was like, oh my God. So, I'm so excited. Through the miracles God did for me, He got me a job, a government job, actually. So I'm grateful to God. And the testimonies are too much. I just want to say thank you, Pastor T. It's been, I don't know, I'm speechless. I don't know what to say, but your teachings, your love, your guidance, it means a lot to me. Oh. Thank you.
Celebrate God this morning. It's the doing of the Lord, and it's marvelous in our eyes. Hallelujah. The Bible says we'll keep rescuing us. Keep rescuing us. For as many times that we need rescuing, God will keep doing what? Rescuing us. Hallelujah. The sound of joy will not cease from habitation in Jesus' name. The next segment in this service, I'd like to welcome Pastor T as we take it out.
And in recognition of that, we don't want that to go uncelebrated or marked. He says, see, we like to sow to the life of the elderly ones among us, because we also want to get to that age in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So during the week, Air Vice Marshal Delimuno and wife were a year older. Hallelujah. God added another year to their year. And also, Uncle Taye, that's Uncle T, also added another year. So, in celebration of that, can we have the cakes on stage, please? Thank you, service team. Hallelujah. Well done. Sorry. Well, praise God. Hallelujah. Okay, please, can we have Uncle T, Air Vice Marshal, and wife on, hallelujah, on stage, please. Celebrate them as they come. Hallelujah. You are welcome, mommy. Thank you, daddy. Hallelujah. Ooh. Yeah, I forgot. Okay. Okay, please bring it. Hallelujah. They want me to break my protocol this morning, and they should not make me do that again. But because of who she is, I will accommodate her. But won't do that again. I told you, cutting for HOT, cutting for anybody, should be done at after service. This is exclusively for elders. I don't like ambush. Okay? Exclusive for elders. The care team got a cake for Sister Josephine, because she too was a year older during the week. So because of her, I can't be eating her food every Sunday and be mean to her. So for the sake of the food, because I don't want the food to stop, she cooks for me every Sunday. I'm not joking, no. She cooks for me every Sunday. All of you wicked people that's not giving me ordinary granite. She cooks for me every Sunday and every Wednesday. I'm not joking, no. She cooks for me every Sunday and every Wednesday. She cooks for me every Sunday and every Wednesday. Every Sunday of the month, she cooks for me. Every Wednesday of the month, she cooks for me. Every Sunday of the year, she cooks for me. Every Wednesday of the year, she cooks for me. Every Sunday of the decade. And if you think I'm joking, I'm not joking. She has been doing that for the past 10 years. Every Sunday, every Wednesday. I'm not joking. So you cannot eat our food and be mean to her. So please welcome my dear sister, Sister Josephine. Paje, join your wife now. Hallelujah. So we call the cakes one after the other. So we are going to call here Vice Marshal and the wife to step forward first. Hallelujah. Is Debbie here and some of the kids? I know some of the kids are here. And the in-law, I know Dan is all over the place. Okay, see Debbie. Debbie is here. Hallelujah. Okay, praise God. And if you kids of Uncle T, and please join. Lekon. Oh, I say if you are your Uncle T's kid, Lekon. Okay, praise God. AVM, we celebrate you.
Yes, sir.
Ma, we celebrate you. Thank you for your wisdom.
Yes.
Thank you for your stability. Thank you for being dear for us. Both seen and unseen, the blessings you have been to us, we are truly very grateful. May God bless you.
Amen.
May God increase your years.
Amen.
And may God multiply your days in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Please cut your cake. Time to cut your cake. At the spell of grace, we do that. Okay, which one is this? The one that big. Okay, which one? We are the one that. Okay, which one is this? Huh? The blue one is this. Please, blue one. Okay, at the spell of grace, they can call their cake. Say G R A C E. God bless you. God bless. Thank you. The word, thank you.
Yes.
A man that writes good things about me all the time.
Yes.
Thank you. I really appreciate your wisdom. Thank you for your humility. Thank you for blending. Thank you for blending. Thank you for just being Okuti. We will celebrate you. Okay. It's not a day for a lot of speech. Okay. I should speak about her. Okay. Thank you for losing weight.
Mm-hmm.
She's been losing a lot of weight. I said, Auntie Faith, this is enough. She's enough, you know, and she just wants to go, but don't go lower than this. You are okay now. You are very okay now. We don't want you to disappear. You are okay now. Rapture has not come. Are you hearing me? But you look beautiful. You look beautiful. Thank you for your sweet spirit. Hallelujah. Okay, please, Uncle T. At first. No, not the blue one, the purple one. Yes, Uncle T knows, of course. Okay, at the spell of grace, they can call KSG. Yes. Hallelujah. Many happy returns, sir. In the name of Jesus. Okay. Sister Josephine. I feel like singing for you, but they won't understand what I'm saying. Singing. No, I will spoil this. I will spoil the service if I sing. If I sing, a lot of you will leave the service. Hallelujah. Okay. Praise God. But thank you. Thank you. Honestly, thank you. That's all I can say. I mean, thank you. So many things are wrapped in that thank you. But thank you. Paje, God bless you. God bless you. You know, this couple, I think I've known them for, I don't know, maybe like 30 years or so. Yeah. It's been a long time. Been for a long time. Praise God. So please put your hands and then let's do it for them again. Say G R A C E. What's that? Hallelujah. Okay. Solomon Lange?
No.
Okay. Let's just pray for them. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this, our elders. We are very grateful. Thank you for giving them to us. Thank you for the value, the quality, the examples. Thank you, Aunt Josephine. God bless you. Hallelujah. Congratulations.
Hallelujah. Praise God. All right, taking us further in the service, let's welcome the Imperials as they be a blessing to us this morning.
Amen. Amen. So we the Imperials, we've tested the goodness of God this morning, and we just come to sing about His faithfulness. Amen. So just join us as we sing about the goodness of God.
Thank you, my God. Oh, thank you, my God. Oh. If I say make I count, they go break, they go dark, I go they count, I go they count, I go they count all the things where God they do for my life. Number one, number two, number three, number four, number five, yeah.
For you in lack and want is the same God God is Jehovah, my great provider. So tell me why you've given up on God. So tell me why you've given up on Him.
No one like you,
no one like you,
Jesus.
No one like you,
no one like you,
Jesus.
Yes. time and age, I believe that we all need that true friend. That friend that is loyal and true. That friend that is reliable, that is dependable. That friend that has a shoulder that is broad enough to carry any load that you throw at him. And I'm here to tell you that Jesus is that friend. That friend that sticks closer than a brother. That friend that has a shoulder that is big enough to carry any load that you throw at him. He is that true friend. I want us to take advantage of that friendship today. Take advantage of that friendship today. Cast all your bodies on him. He's that true friend that we need. That's the kind of friendship we have in Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Take our seat. Let's celebrate the Imperials one more time. Thank you. Hallelujah. You know, I've always told this church, take risks. Take risks. Don't worry yourself, just take risk. You know how that groom came up, how they came about? It was, what's the name of this young man? Jaffe came to my office, we were planning for this month. I said, okay, you know, what artists are we featuring? I said, what artists are we featuring? Which artist? We have artists in church. I said, let's form a group called Imperious. The name just came. I said, we call them Imperious. He said, who are the members of the team? I said, you know that boy that when he sings, you see left hand, one yellow boy. He said, yeah, man. I said, put his name there. I didn't know his name. Put his name there. I said, that boy that last to rap, put his name there. And before you know it, we had five of them. And so that is it. Get a lawyer. Let's write it. Let's Imperious. Yes, now. Look, let me warn you, eh? Somebody will go and register the name now. Yes. When it's time for you to register, you now begin to beg the person. Yes. Who knows where God will take you? Yes. Now, so in the beginning. Yes. Yeah. Glory be to God. So, we'll think for. Group again. We'll think of a name, you know. Yeah, so I started. Oh, okay, good one. Let's go. So, Father, we thank in the name of Jesus. We thank because our gathering together is unto you. Glorify yourself here. Thank for the anointing to teach and to preach. Grace to understand in the name of Jesus and power to do. We declare this atmosphere free for your spirit to move. Let somebody be encouraged. Let somebody be built up. Let somebody have light. In the name of Jesus Christ. We thank for our nation Nigeria, because in our very lifetime, there shall be a turnaround to the glory of your name. In the name of Jesus. Blessed be your name, Father. In the mighty name of Jesus, we are praying. Amen. Before you take your seat, celebrate the Lord. Greet your neighbor warmly. Hallelujah. Okay. Greet your neighbor once again. Tell them you're happy to see them as you take your seat. God bless you, choir. Thank you. Hallelujah. Okay, we'll rush a little bit this morning, and we'll talk to God for a good time. Hallelujah. I feel funny wearing this suit again. Yeah, I actually came with Agbada this morning, but it's in this. I wanted to change. But because we had another service earlier on, so let me just wear suit today. Next week I will resume. Hallelujah. I feel free. I'm just liking those natives now. I'm feeling free. This one. I'm feeling less free. I don't want to say I feel bound. Okay. Eh? It's serious, Abby. Praise God. So, just a few announcements. First of all, it's not an announcement, but I want to say a big thank you to every one of you that launched the book, that gave, that worked on making that last weekend a success. God bless every one of you. Celebrate yourself now. Eh? I know some of you didn't give at all. But on behalf of those who gave, thank you. God bless you. Hallelujah. Please, all the doctors that were announced earlier on, let's catch up. And next Sunday, we are having a superlative drama in church. It's going to be an awesome, awesome time. Just because it's a month for evangelism, we're just doing things different in a way. Glory be to God. So please invite your friend and those of you workers that didn't come yesterday. That is not good. I don't know what you are doing. We plan this. They want to do evangelism this month. Come out. All this pursuit you are chasing, this thing that will not favor your government in eternity. Why are you wasting your... I don't get it. Live a balanced life. Be spiritual. At the same time, be... I don't want to say use the word be carnal. Be secular. Do what you need to do. But live a balanced life. Glory be to God forevermore. Don't just waste your life pursuing secular things. So at the end of the day, you look back. What has your life counted for? Let's make our lives count for the kingdom of God. Glory be to God forevermore. Please help us with those children that are restless. Take them out. Give them food. When they are sleeping, bring them back. Okay. Or better still, if you think that they are making noise, you draw them inside the offering box. Let's go. Okay. That's all. I finished my announcement. Praise God. I want to continue the series we have been doing. There are some noises here. Help me to muffle them, maybe from the light or something. Okay. On the blessing, glory be to God forevermore. We are looking at the components of the blessing. Today we look at the last component of the blessing. The last one, we talk about several components, okay? By the grace of God, maybe next week we go to the scope of the blessing. And afterward, we go to how to activate and walk in the blessing. But today we'll be rounding up on part one, which is about subsection. I don't know how many under part one. Okay, maybe the fourth one under the component of the blessing. Proverbs chapter 10. Proverbs chapter 10. Verse 22. Thomas, come. Hallelujah. Okay. If you are above 40 generally of age, and you don't, this by the way, that's not, I've not said what I want to say. If you are 40 years and above, and you are not, please, what will you call ifunra in English? Eh? No, I'm not joking. It's a funeral. It's not a funeral. I'm not. Not discernment, but yeah, and you are not sensitive. Sensitive can be negative. Sensitive people can be too critical. Yeah, you should be alert. You should be intuitive and be not intuitive. You should be alert generally. Just ability to observe. Yeah, be observant. Yeah, be generally very observant about your body, about your health. If you notice something growing somewhere that's not been there before, please, we didn't organize this service for these children. You know, if you notice that your body's something, consult a doctor. Are you hearing me? If you notice anything anywhere, just generally, when you come, you'll be observant. Where did you put your teeth? Just be observant generally. Not that you say, no, na so it be, na so it be. No, be na so it be. You get what I'm trying to say? Because you will prevent a whole lot of things. Now, I came yesterday, I stood outside the church. I said, no, this chiller is making noise. I don't know what it was. Because we had a meeting here yesterday or something. I said, no, this is noisy. They said, no. I came here this morning. I said, this is noisy. Do you notice you are not hearing that noise again now? He said, no, that's why they make noise. Am I coming to church for the very first time? They are machines. Things will go wrong. Just listen. Even your house, generally, when you open your fridge, that's how some of you will take things or you will not notice. No. I may have, I don't have many clothes. Take one. Just take one. If I don't know that day, give me that week. And the way my own works is that week, I will remember that one. Generally, have that. It will help you. Glory be to God forevermore. The blessing of the Lord, it makes what? Rich. And he has no sorrow with you. Say amen to that. Amen. And we said, don't want to do a lot of review. We said we have been blessed because we are in Christ. I've been blessed because we're in Christ. Tell your neighbor, I've been blessed because I'm in Christ. For Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. No, that's what the Bible, I'm just quoting the Bible. The Bible says Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law having become a curse for us, written, curse is everyone that hangs on a tree, that the blessing of Abraham might come upon us Gentiles, and may have the promise of the Spirit. Glory be to God forevermore. Galatians chapter 3, verse 13 and 14. That's what the Bible says. The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 1, verse 3, blessed be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places. The Bible says in Galatians chapter 3, verse 8, the Bible says, those who believe are blessed with the believing Abraham. Say amen to that. We are blessed. Glory be to God forevermore. The Bible says the blessing of God makes one rich. It has ingredients, and when they mix it together, at the end of it, you'll be rich. Glory be to God forevermore. So we now began to unravel what are the components of the blessing. We said one of the components of the blessing is the presence of God. Hallelujah. We said also another component of the blessing is what we called gifts, talents, and callings. We also said wisdom is also part of the blessing, which helps you to transform your gift into a marketable stuff. Glory be to God forevermore. We also said favor of God is part of the blessing. We also said what again? Opportunities, part of the blessing. Divine relationships, they are also part of the blessing. Divine protection is also part of the blessing, because it's the blessing of God for a man to labor and enjoy the fruit of his labor. All these seven things are all part of the component. Now I want to tell you the last part of it, which is not all, but I will stop on this particular one. Glory be to God. Some of you may not like it, but I want to tell you, please, you know, I've not started preaching right now. Some of you are dozing already. You know, stop it. It's demonic. Don't doze. It's a height of carnality for you to be dozing at the moment. When they were saying, you know, ba ya ba, ba ba ya ba, ba ba ba, now you are dancing. Some of you, you know, I don't know how to interpret your life. Honestly, it's difficult for me. It's difficult. In fact, what I've been talking about today, maybe it will help some of you. Maybe. Because until you go to certain things in life, don't tell me you know what you are doing. Don't tell me you are blessed. What have you gone through? Somebody that has not, you know, gone through anything will come and say you are blessed because you have a good job. No, no, no. What do you mean by that? You are talented, you are gifted, you know people. You say you are blessed. What do you know about that? What do you know about blessing? Until those things are taken away and you can still come out and bounce back, that's when you know you are blessed. Yeah. Oh, we're talking, you've not gone through anything, you will say you are blessed. I remember a guy that used to make mouth in those days, be telling how to spend money. You know, spend money. His brother was in Senate. Why don't you be talking? His brother left Senate 6 months after he sold his car, he sold his house. Because he wasn't really blessed. He was blessed because Bible never talk about the blessing of Lot. Bible talk about the blessing of Abraham. Lot was only blessed because of Abraham. If Abraham was taken away, everything that Lot had would dry off. You must go through your own trial and have your own testimony. Are you hearing what I'm talking about right now? A lot of people said, what do you know about blessing? So you can come to church and sleep now because you're not going through anything. When you say, pen, uncle will give, pen, sister will give, pen, boss will give, pen, boyfriend will give, why would you sleep? No, why would you sleep? When you go through stuff, you will be alert. Where your life depends on hearing the word of God, you'll be alert. Yes, sir. You'll be alert. What have you gone through? And that is why I must teach this today. Because the body of Christ must be matured. You want me to just talk about the blessing of God, favor of God. They are all part of it. We have all those things. We still go through what we are going through. It's when we come out at the end of it that you can look back and say you are blessed. What have some of you gone through? That's why some of you will keep mismanaging opportunities, mismanaging favor, because you have not gone through anything. In fact, you won't take this for granted. Some of you will look at this and have a sense of entitlement, because you have not gone through anything. You are not even grateful for any people who give you money, give you 100,000, say, now look, despite all that is worth, now 100,000 give me. Nonsense. If you know, no, what if you gave you 100? What will you do? You need to get rid of all this stupid sense of entitlement. It's all this, what I'm about to teach you today, will cure you of all that. Glory be to God for come on. So number 8 component of the blessing is what I call trials. It's a blessing. You think it was for nothing that the psalmist said
It was good that I was afflicted. Look at how arrogant you were before. Look at how humble you are now. Because you never need to go through what you are going through right now. When your security is taken away, you have no other place to turn to God. Hallelujah. Young people, can you hear what I'm talking about right now? Because a lot of people, we are blessed. Someone, come, let me pray for you, be blessed. Look, when you are asking God to bless you, be careful. Because it may take you through a journey that you will not like. But at the end, that it will do you better, like your later end, than your beginning. Say amen to that. Amen. The time some of you apply for visa, if you got it that time, you will be in prison by now. If you have got that visa that time, if you went to America that time, we go to rescue you in prison. You and Hush Puppy, you'll be in the same prison by now. Somewhere in California, that's where you'll be by now. Because you don't, it's true now. You will just see girls. Ah! See this old Igbo? Ah! You are on your way. So you know, number one, you are black. Number two, you are African. Number three, you are a man. You are endangered species. Whatever a woman says against you is correct. Whatever a white says against black is correct. When you are taken before the judge, you will be sleeping. I'm not joking. Because he has made up his mind. You just woke up from the sleep, say 15 years. You've not been there, I've been there. I've lived with them and see, I know their mindset. So thank God that they deny you that time. Because with the heart you are going with. Thank God you didn't marry that time, you wanted to marry. Because you were uncooked, unprepared, indisciplined, barbaric, African mindset. You have gone to ruin your sister's life. But thank God it prevented you. Thank God you didn't get that car that time. By now. Because your mindset that time was, if I get this car, hey, yeah, yeah! They will hear it worldwide. Thank God. He allowed you to see life. He allowed you to have that accident that time. The one that provided a cut here. Now you know how it feels. Now you temper life with. Yeah. Do you get what I'm trying to say right now? Yes, glory be to God. Psalm 66. Woo! It's a blessing, honestly. It's a blessing. It's a blessing that you went through what you are going through. If you have not pastored a small church before, once your church grows, you started your church growth. This is what you'll be doing. I see formula for church growth. When you do seminar, you'll be blaming those who have small churches. I see they don't know what they are doing. You'll be talking loud. I see they are calling on a different God. You don't know it's God that just favored you. You'll be providing formula for church growth. You. What do you mean by church growth? Pride. Verse 8. Are you happy you came to church this morning?
Yeah.
Ah. What are you talking about? Thank God. God heard you till now before you have money. I know people that ruin banks, children that ruin their father's bank, that a smaller bank had to buy it up because they were uncooked children. Can you imagine somebody ruins a bank because of frivolous lifestyle? California today, Miami tomorrow, chartered flight. Where are you going? On other people's money. On their life. That's why you hardly find any business in Nigeria that survives the second generation. Yeah. Because the children are totally uncooked for what is committed to their hand. Arik cannot survive. Can you imagine Arik died? Arik died in the first generation. Arik died. He's taken over by Amcon. Ah! What a catastrophe. And some of you can't understand what I'm saying. You're just looking at me. Hey, okay, what is Eric? No, Eric is that restaurant at the junction. What is Eric? I say, some of you give your children money, you don't give them principles. You are killing them. You didn't tell them what made you to become what you are. You are giving them what you have. It doesn't work. Hey, are you happy this morning? If he didn't spare his own son, he made him go through suffering. Bible said, what about the sufferings of Christ and the glory afterward? Made the voice of his praise to be what? None of you that praise God in silence. There's something called silence praise. If you praise God, it must be heard. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. As you sit beside somebody, oh Father, I give you praise. Say, what is that? I'm praising God. His voice of praise must be what? Be heard. Must be heard. There's nothing called a silent, grateful man. It doesn't exist. There's no, Bible said the leper, from afar off, began to praise him, thank him. There's no silent grateful man. It's not work. Glory be to God forever. Let his voice be heard. Verse 9, let's go on. Who kissed our soul among the living? Say amen to that. Amen. He kissed our soul, what? Among the living. Wow. And does not allow our feet to be what? Moved. May the Lord keep you secure. Amen. I say, may the Lord keep you secure. Amen. I say it again. I say, may the Lord keep you secure. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You are not smart enough to keep yourself secure. You know that? He doesn't allow our feet to move. He said, you, oh God, look at you. Oh God, oh God. This is not Satan. My sister, not Satan. No. You have referred. Eva is referred. What into the world? My God. You will see it just because you are a child. That's somewhere you are going. He has brought us into the net. You laid afflictions on our back. Do you say that? You laid afflictions on our back. But look at us. Look at us meant to ride over our heads. All of a sudden, you will like you. They will stop liking you. Meanwhile, you are the live wire of that team. Men will ride over your head. All of a sudden, you see your junior. Sometimes you will see people who are junior to you, rude to you. Yeah. Have you been there before? Hey, yeah, yeah. I'm not talking about outside, though, even inside church. You will see rude to you for not. If against you, may the Lord accept sacrifice. But if it's men that stir them up against you, may judgment of God be upon them. You don't. That's not good for you at all. You went. Look at it. I know those who are dozing and those who are alive. She went small. it is God them against you. Because God can tear up people's hearts against you. Because he knows where he's going. If it's God that tear them up against you, may he accept sacrifice. Amen. May he accept fasting and prayer. Amen. May he accept siege. Obedience. So that their heart can melt towards you. But if it's men against you, may the judgment of God be upon them. Amen. Because some people are naturally evil. They divide the best of friends. They sow seed of discord. You have caused men to. We went through. But look again. But you. This place in New Living Translation. Hallelujah. May God bring you out. Amen. He said, we went through this, we went through that, but what? You do you know something? Do you know something? You can between the time you went in and the time you came out.
No.
You can never be the same. He was the one that he will be the one that will bring you out. Can bring you out. That's why your uncles are not picking your call. That's why your boyfriend turned you down. That's why you refuse to. Your friends seem as if their night is busy. Because it's God that took you. Until God decided to bring you out, you will be there for some time. Nobody's answering me this morning. They don't like what I'm saying. Thou likest not what I say it. But I say the truth. Thou can read it. You put us through it, but you will lead us out. Look at what it says. Then you put a lid on us. But you brought us to a place of great abundance. That means at the end, the trial is a blessing. The blessing of the Lord made you rich. The trial made you rich now. Great abundance. That's what I'm talking about. Glory be to God forevermore. So all this one that you, small thing will happen to you, you will give up. I'm not coming to church again. God has turned against me. God is not answering. No. Stop it. It's not afraid to let him pray. Are you hearing me? Stop it. God has hated me. God turned against me. God has left me behind. Who told you? When he said, I will never leave you or forsake you. He will never leave you. There's nothing you can do that will make him to leave you.
Oh, Father, I thank
you. Leaving you will be him breaking his word. Hallelujah. I was reading my scriptures. I said, every branch in me that bears fruit, he prunes. I thought the one that branch that I thought care of the one that's bearing fruit. It says it will prune so that we. That means we are doing well. But, hallelujah. I thought it will prune the one that doesn't bear fruit. It's the one that is bearing fruit. It's not easy. Now that thing with chaka. Relationship, chaka. Work, chaka. Finances, chaka. But when you come out of it, more fruits. More fruit. That it may bear more fruit. Is somebody getting what we are trying to say here today? Yes, that it may bear more fruit. So now you have a positive perception of what you are going through. Glory be to God forevermore. Yes. But you still brought us to reach fulfillment. You brought us out to a place of abundance. Give me in King James Version. I love the way King James Version puts it. Verse 12. I need to make progress. Hallelujah. It said, thou hast caught. Yeah, that is good English now. Has caused men to ride over our heads. What it means for men to walk over your head? To mash you, to whoosh you. What? It looks like simple when you are reading it. But when it's happening, in real life, it's not easy. But thou broughtest us out into a what? A well. Hallelujah! Where the place? May you all said and done. May you come out in the way. In the name of Jesus Christ. Worth experience. Worth of character. Worth of endurance. May you come worth of plenty of money. Plenty of influence. May you come out in a worthy place. In the name of Jesus Christ. Worthy place. So it's a blessing. Amen. It's a blessing. 2 Corinthians chapter 4. 2 Corinthians chapter 4. Don't let me, I don't want to talk about it. Some of you don't even know what to mean inside church and everybody is singing and you are crying. You don't know what it means. You're not being there. It has happened to me. Everybody is singing and crying. Because you will turn every way out. Every door. It's because some of you have not been attacked and left for dead before. You have not got it to a place where Lazarus got to. And we say by now it's stinketh. Until the spirit of your life. You've not been there. Wow. Go to verse 16 somewhere. I hope I can get it right. Uh-huh. Look at this. Therefore, what? Lose hearts. Tell your neighbor, don't lose hearts. Don't be a weak person, man. Therefore, we do not what? Lose heart. We don't. He says what? Even though our outward man is perishing, yet our inward is being renewed day by day. We refuse to give up. We refuse. Verse 17. For our what? Our light affliction. Which is what? But for what? A moment. Is what is working for us. Is it working against you? Is working what? For us. Are you hearing me? Your uncle drove you out of the house. It is working for you. They attacked you. It's working for you. Do you know what I'm saying right now? Our affliction is working for us. A far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. Verse 18. Why do not look at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen? For the things which are seen are what? Temporary. But the things which are not seen are what? Eternal. We don't focus on those things. It's working for us. Say amen to that.
Amen.
In laws gathered against you is working for you. Being despised is working for you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
You are supposed to sit in front, they put your place, not at the back, somewhere hidden. It is working for you.
Hallelujah.
Wonder why churches don't teach this? He said, come, if you have been denied, let me pray for you. What is prayer? What is praying for you? Who has God forgotten? Who, look, in the recess, who has God forgotten? Your uncle may forget. He doesn't forget. Bible says even your parents can forget. Bible says it's possible for a mother to describe your name. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody say everything. Just call me tomorrow and after all, or the day after, and then you call. And the person say, who is this? Who is this? It was one that chairman introduced you. Okay. That was about 3 days ago. Okay. I'll get back to you. That back has not been backed yet. Maybe they will get back on Monday, tomorrow. If not, what have you seen? Please, don't let me slap that girl. Tell her to go outside. Go outside. You hear me? Stand up on it. Go. Just go outside. No, no. Yeah, go, 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 go. Yeah. Go. Okay. You think I'm looking for a crowd? Yeah. That annoys me not. I came near her. I went there to preach. She slept. I came near her again. She continued sleeping. Don't sleep. You look, there are many people who can go and enjoy your good day rest. You think I'm one of these pastors who won't pray all night? I went to bed around 1. I was up before 4. I'm only banking that when I get back today, I will sleep in the afternoon. You get your heart, prepare everything. Somebody will come to church and... Because you are used to what you see. Carry my water for head, you. He na so in na fa. You better know what God is telling you. Instead of entertaining yourself. Yeah. I'm gonna tell some of you. I'm not going through it. I'm not going through it. If you want to sleep, rent a hotel. If you want to hear the word, come to church. And you know something about those bad attitudes? It's infectious. Because once I start sleeping, other people will follow. Because it's demonic. Hallelujah. Don't clap. Don't worry yourself. Hallelujah. And what some of you are thinking now? What if it's an unbeliever? Let him go and be a believer. Are you the first? You are not the first believer. There are many unbelievers. Even we too were unbelievers before. Are you here? You are spot unbeliever. Tell me about all those unbeliever excuses. It's like you go to a nightclub, you refuse to drink. What did you go there to do? No, what did you go there to do? You say I'm a Christian. What did you go there? Waiting? No. You are a Christian. What are you finding in the high priest place? No. You are a Christian. What are you finding in the nightclub? You say I don't dance. What? What are you doing there? What are you doing there? Have you seen because you are unbeliever, you are a believer, you went to the club, they will now send your own. It's the same price. So don't say because you are unbeliever, you come to church, it's the same standard. The same standard.
Yeah.
Because you will not hear because you are sleeping. Because all of you, I can see people's face. This man had life. What have you been through? I've told you before. I've scouted some places in this town. I scouted there one night. I just went to Scott because I scouted in over 40 places. No, I'm the chairman of. I scouted it. So I went to that place. This was how the woman, I'm not joking, it was son that took me there. This three son I traveled. So now it was okay, my house is free. Travel now, so you can pass it, you can stay there. Please, come. Give me the seat. Give me that seat. When I got to the house, this is how the mother was looking at me. Nobody told me to leave. Nobody! What? Ma'am, take it to you. You think you want to see? What have you seen? I've slept on hard floor. Hard floor. The ties with clothes. I told you, I will be watching TV. The one girl was there looking at me like this. She doesn't know that when we are going through stuff, nothing works. She'll be looking at me. Mean that I'm going through, I know where I was supposed to be in life. I know where I was. Are you used to have house. Now I am begging where to sleep. I lost all. So the next thing to me is to be looking at one girl and be doing like this. Me. And I was dead. I came back one day. The lady carried my phone. Carried it back inside. We call you here to come and be doing the work of God. You are carry my phone. I started sleeping on the floor. I'm talking about. Why would you sleep? What have you gone through? Why would you not look at the things which are saying, but at the things which are saying? Quick, by today, let me begin to round up. Let me tell you four things that trial will do for you. Four things that trial will do for you. Number one. Number one. Thing that trial will do for you. Trial will reveal to you the heart of men towards you. That's number one thing trial will do for you. It will reveal to you the true heart of men towards you. Did you get it? Should I repeat? Your Bible is there, Abby. Yeah, let me give you another Bible. You are a good person. You are always writing. Let me give you a better pen. Give me one of those, my pen. Where's Bros J? Please give me another pen here. Thank you. He's writing. Some of you don't write anything in church. You must be crazy. Are you that intelligent? Hallelujah. No, that's a bad one. It's a good man. Let him write. Hallelujah. Some of you are supposed to collect your daughter because you are never writing. Number one thing that trial will do for you, it will reveal the true heart of men towards you. Yeah. Anybody when they come, when you have money, who will come? Who not go come? Number two, Lazarus Crescent. You will see your friend come here. Even your classmate, primary school classmate will show up. Wow. Are you still in touch with Tony? Say, no, I've not seen Tony for a long time. Wow. Actually, I thought you guys were married. So it didn't work out. I said, it didn't work out. Wow. Serve them. Serve them. Everybody will enjoy that. But make it remain small, make it rich. Their phone will be switched off. Something happened to me one day. I nearly died. I'm not joking. I was pastoring a church in town. And then, my boss came back. So that means I had to step back, let him occupy. So I will be quiet in meetings, Sam, because there can't be two captains in the ship. So I will just be looking. And I don't see people jocketing politics. I will just be looking. No comment, nothing. I'll be looking. So one day we went for a meeting, and the meeting we draw because everybody wants their opinion to be heard. Everybody will say this. Actually, the way to move this church forward, people who can move their life forward, they want to move church forward. I'll be looking at all of them. Be around. That's how I'm going to look. Some of them will come and do SWOT analysis. SWOT analysis for outside. For you. Hope you are.